Good morning, human geography folks. Hopefully you guys are having a nice Thursday and you're ready to attack some human geography content. We're still in Unit 4, still looking at the Middle East and the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. And you guys have been doing a great job so far, so keep up the good work. My goal for this video announcement is to keep it under 5 or 6 minutes, keep it quick. So I'm just going to get right into what we're getting into today. Just a quick word about grades. Remember, your grade at the third quarter can't go down from whatever it was at the third quarter. Grades cannot go down from here on out, but they can go up. So if you would like to see your grade raise by up to 10%, make sure you're doing this distance learning work. You could also be turning in work from before we went on break to raise your grade further. But if you are completing the distance learning work that is being assigned, you will see a 10% improvement in your grade. Now, I have had a couple students asking me questions about when their grade will reflect that 10% raise. The way grades are kind of working out with this distance learning, it's difficult for me to have your grade immediately reflect work that you've done. It's actually going to be easier if I go back, if I go into the grade book at the end of the semester and just add 10% to all of the students who have earned that 10% grade bump. So as you're doing this distance learning work and you're not seeing your grade improve, just know that if you do the work and you're doing it well, you're going to see up to a 10% improvement of that grade. It will just come at the end of the semester. So if your parents are wondering why you still have an 84%, even though you've been doing all of the distance learning work, you can let your parents know that you should be up at around a 94% if you continue doing the distance learning work. So kind of some incentive to keep working. I mean, and it shouldn't all be about grades. Okay, there should be some intrinsic incentive, like you actually want to learn the material. You want to become a more well-rounded human being, a more knowledgeable human being. But you can also get that improvement on your grade as well. So make sure you're taking care of that. On the housekeeping slide, as usual, I tell you what items were assigned 2 classes ago and what items were assigned last class. Going to the items that were assigned last class, you had the CNN 10 discussion, which you guys always do a really good job at. And then you had the quote analysis discussion where you were looking at 2 quotes concerning the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. And I was kind of asking you to analyze those quotes, figure out where the bias was in those quotes. And judging by the Schoology discussion that I looked at, you guys seem to really understand what bias was. Essentially, it's prejudice in favor or against something. Another word for bias might be like favoritism. And you guys really seem to grasp that concept, which is great. And you guys were, from what I saw in the discussion, able to accurately identify the bias in the 2 quotes. Obviously, you had 1 quote from the Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, and that quote was pretty clearly bias in favor of the Israelis, which makes sense that the Prime Minister of Israel is going to favor the Israelis. Okay, and then you had the other quote from the American journalist Chris Hedges, and that quote was pretty clearly bias in favor of the Palestinian cause, kind of showing their side of things. So, it's real important to be able to identify bias, especially this day and age. We get so much information from so many different sources, some of them good, some of them questionable. And being able to identify the bias of a given source is super important in determining whether or not you should listen to that information, or if you need to take that information with a grain of salt. To kind of put this in more kind of realistic terms for you, like the coronavirus, for example. There's a lot of different information you're hearing about the coronavirus. Well, depending on the bias of the source you're getting that information from, that's going to influence what type of information you are getting. So it's really important to know, first of all, where the information is coming from. And by knowing where it's coming from, you can oftentimes identify what the bias of that source is. Okay, and bias in and of itself is not a bad thing. Because remember, everybody inevitably has bias. We all have our own individual, unique perspective that we're coming at things from. Okay, so it's not bad to have bias, but it's important that you know where the bias lies. Okay, that way you're not having the wool pulled over your eyes. You're not being led down some intellectual path that you don't really want to go down, because you kind of know what the bias is behind any given source. So it's a really important tool to apply to just current events and news in general. And then you guys did take quiz number 6 last class on the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. Hopefully you're able to get a perfect score on that quiz. You did get multiple attempts, so you should be able to get a perfect score. And remember, you get to use the notes that you had taken on the video and the reading that you did. So shouldn't be any issues with that quiz. And then today, we still have that Middle East geography review game going. And man, those times that you guys are posting are fast. I got on last night and I was like, okay, I want to see what Mr. Bergman can get. Because Cherry emailed me last night with a 17-second score. And we got Saprit with 18 seconds, Shabika with 20 seconds. I mean, there's a lot of really, really fast scores. Leah with 21. And there's 17 countries in the Middle East that they're asking you to identify on that game. Some of them are really, really small. They're tough to click. I played it last night and I thought I was going pretty quick and I got 28 seconds. So those of you getting 17 seconds, 22 seconds, 24 seconds, that is impressive. There's no doubt in my mind that you guys know that Middle East geography and you're very, very quick with a mouse. So keep up the good work. I don't see anybody beating Cherry's 17 seconds. You're going to have to go quicker than 1 second per country, but we'll see. Today's CNN 10 discussion, we are looking at, it's a pretty interesting phenomenon going on in our world due to the pandemic and the quarantine that's resulted from the coronavirus pandemic. And one of the interesting things that's happened is air quality has changed. So I want you to, that's kind of what CNN 10 is going to be talking about in their episode. But there's some pretty cool questions for you to discuss with your classmates. And then I want you to respond to one of your classmates' posts. The way I have these discussions kind of organized is that you shouldn't be able to see your classmates' posts until you respond. Okay, if I've set things up properly, that should be the case. So that when you respond initially, you can't see any of your classmates' responses. But once you've responded, then you can see your classmates' posts and you can respond to one of those posts. So keep up with those CNN 10 discussions because that is part of this distance learning work. And I think it's important to be informed, especially these days. You got to know what's going on because the information seems to change so quickly. After the CNN discussion, I've got another discussion. As you notice, we are a discussion-heavy class these days, but it works well for us. This next discussion is an image analysis discussion. I have an image that I want you guys to look and dissect and kind of tell me what's happening in the image. It's okay to be wrong. Okay, you're probably inevitably going to be wrong if you're making educated guesses. But go ahead and kind of analyze the image that I've posted there for you, and then you're going to respond to one of your classmates' posts, kind of responding to their analysis of the image. Maybe they saw something you didn't. Maybe you disagree with what they're kind of interpreting the image to be. So have a nice little discussion. It's one of my favorite images concerning the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. It was taken, the picture was taken, I think, a year and a half ago or so, so it's a pretty recent image. And it's a powerful image. So get after that. And then last but not least today, I've got a journal number 4 for you. This journal number 4 is essentially intended for you to review the concept of bias that we introduced last class, still looking at the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. As with any journal, you have as many attempts as it takes to get a perfect score. Okay, these journals are meant to be for practice. So if it takes you a couple attempts to get a perfect score, that's totally fine. It's good practice for you. So you've got two discussions and one journal to get through today, as well as any work that you may have missed in previous lessons. Make sure you're taking care of that. And remember the grades comment I made earlier on in the video. Okay, if you're doing the distance learning work, you will see a 10% raise in your grade, but it's not going to be applied until the end of the semester. So just kind of keep that in mind when you're looking at your grade. Okay, I said I was going to be below 5 or 6 minutes, and it is 9 minutes and 30 seconds. So we're keeping it under 10 minutes today. That's not bad. Good job, Mr. Bergman. Keep up the good work. Yeah, I mean, that's all I got for you guys today. I miss you. I miss seeing your smiling faces. Hopefully we can all be back at school sooner rather than later. I know as a water polo coach, I want to play my fall sports in the water. So we are definitely crossing our fingers that I will see you guys come August. Have a good one.